Perfect.
Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be reviewing this bomb unit sent to me by Unique Hair Supply. Now, if you have not heard of Unique Hair Supply, honey, they have been around since 2014 and are located in Houston, Texas. However, your girl is here to show you guys how bomb this unit is and my whole process that I go through when I get a new wig and kind of the start to finish of that, especially for my beginners out there. I made a very detailed video for you guys in order to kind of follow along. And today I went ahead and tried out a new method for installing this unit without using any type of glue, honey. So if you want to see how I went ahead and transformed this wig from this to this, honey, then just keep on watching. Alright guys, so like I mentioned in the beginning of this video, the hair that we're going to be using today is from Unique Hair Supply, and they went ahead and sent me their Brazilian straight wig that is about 20 inches long. Now this hair is virgin hair, so it can be dyed and bleached, so we definitely are going to be having some fun with her today, and probably in future videos as well. I have a couple ideas in mind. But this is what the unit is looking like straight out of the box, and let me just say, it was so relieving when I took it out of the packaging to not have like a very strong smell or anything. It smelled very good, almost like they had washed it before. And I thought that was very interesting because some other human haired wigs that I have reviewed in the past definitely have a very strong chemical smell, and honey, like, it just is a major no for me. But when I was looking at this unit, honey, I was not expecting this to come pre-plucked or anything, and I was blown away by this hairline, to be honest, because I'm just so used to having to go in and pluck. But today what we're gonna do is really focus on bleaching those knots. I didn't want to touch anything with the hairline until we bleached the knots, so that is exactly what we're gonna go ahead and do before we put this wig on. Now, I usually start off by spraying some water on my units just to kind of get any type of loose hairs or baby hairs and push them back. However, since this unit was so luscious, I ended up going in with a little bit of the Got to Be spray, and I was spraying it on the hair just to keep everything in place. Now, when you are doing this, please note that I am not spraying it on the hairline, okay? I'm not spraying it anywhere close to that hairline. It's about 2, 3, maybe 4 inches behind, and I'm using my comb to hold the hair in place. Now, what this is gonna do is kind of just keep your hair still. It's not gonna have your hair flying all over, because during the bleaching process, you definitely do not want any bleach on the actual hair strands, or else you are going to possibly have the appearance of it looking like there's a couple bald spots, when in actuality it's just the hair in certain areas is bleached and blotchy. So that is exactly why I did that. Now, for this tutorial, I included some items that you are for sure going to need. You're definitely going to need a mixing bowl, and then you also are going to need some type of bleaching powder. This is the brand that I use. I prefer using Ion with the bleach as well as the developer, because they have a couple different nourishing ingredients apparently, but also it doesn't have a very obnoxious smell while you're using it. So also don't forget your mixing brush, and then as well as a comb in case you need to part anything out. And then also to cut your lace, you can always use a eyebrow razor or scissors, whichever you prefer. And then also the new little method we're trying today is we're going to be transforming this lace front unit into a glueless lace front unit. And I've never done this method before, but Christiana was so nice to go ahead and send me these. So I was like, you know what, we're going to try it for this video. Why not? And then, of course, find a wig cap that kind of matches your skin tone. I've never seen this brand, but they definitely have it a lot of colors. And then again, thank you so much, Unique Hair Supply, for sponsoring this video.
All right, now we are going to go ahead and get into the bleaching the knots process. So first things first, you want to set up a safe work area. You don't want to damage anything around your house, boo-boo. So grab a plastic bag or a trash bag and put it down. Now, pouring the bleach in, I'm only gonna pour about half because I find that if I pour the entire bag, I typically end up wasting a lot of product. So we're gonna take it slow on this. I'm adding a little bit of developer. Now, the consistency that I look for is definitely more of a paste rather than the pancake texture that some other people are saying, because I've messed up a couple units by having the bleach a little bit too runny. So you want to make sure it's very, very thick, not thick enough where it's just dry and cracking, but you'll see just like this, almost like a toothpaste consistency. Now it's not dropping off of the brush, and that is exactly what you want because you don't want the bleach seeping into the knots. And here is a better look at all those knots that we are going to be bleaching today, as well as the hairline. Like I said, you don't want to go in with a new unit and start plucking before you bleach knots because, honey, you might be surprised by the end results once you get done. Now, of course, I'm going to go ahead and put a glove on, only on one hand, and then my secret weapon is using a plastic kit, like little knife. The reason why is because it's so much easier for me to control the amount of pressure I'm using while I'm putting it on the inside of the unit. I find with the brush, it's a very uneven texture, so there's a little bit of inconsistencies that I've experienced when I use the brush. But hey, if you're good with that brush, go ahead and use it, sis. Ain't nobody stopping you. But this is just what I do. I kind of smear it on there, almost similar to like icing on a cake. I don't push very hard, and of course, this is sped up. But you definitely want to take your time with this. Don't press too hard because when your bleach is developing, it'll go ahead and expand. Now I ran out, as you can see, for the middle of the wig. So I went ahead and mixed up a little bit more bleach just to go ahead and finish this off. And now this point, this is the only time I use the, brush to apply the bleach, which is in that little curve of the dome on the head. Because the knife, obviously it's just tool that doesn't bend, so and then I go back in with the knife and then just kind of perfect everything, smooth it out, make sure everything's even, touch up any spots that I may have missed, and really that's it for bleaching the knots. Take your time, don't have your bleach too runny, and then just let it sit for about 30 minutes. I also went ahead and covered it with the plastic bag that we were using just to kind of seal in all the moisture and keep it developing. Now it's time to go ahead and rinse this unit off. This is what it's looking like before I rinse the bleach. As you can see, the bleach almost has like a cloud-like texture because of, you know, it's been developing. So what I go ahead and do is rinse it off with slightly warm water, nothing too hot. And as you can see, baby girl, those knots, like for real, it's a dramatic difference. I will definitely do a side by side, but in order to get rid of some of the brassiness underneath, we're gonna go ahead and apply some of the shimmering lights shampoo and put it on the inside of the wig, because I mean, there's no need to really put it on the outside of the hair. We're focusing on those knots. That's what needs to be toned. And then honestly, I just leave it for about 5 minutes as well. And then you can always check it before you rinse. I suggest that. But if you rinse it and it turns out that you need to go ahead and go in there again, just put it on for another 5 minutes. But also, when I'm rinsing this, I want to mention I rinse it with cold water, and this is before I put conditioner. And let me just say, this hair is some of the softest hair I've worked with for my human hair units. And I had expectations for like what I've experienced in the past, but this wig definitely like took that number one spot. I'm not even playing with y'all. It was so soft. But here I'm gonna go ahead and do a deep conditioning bath. I add a little bit of water into the sink and agitate it a little bit just to mix it up. And then I let the wig soak in there for about 30 minutes. And this is how luscious it looked at the very end. All right, so after doing all of those steps, this is what the hairline is looking like on this unit. And I'll say it again, just like I said it probably already 5 times by now, but do not pluck your unit until you bleach the knots, because honey, look at this. It can save you so much time. And honestly, it just shows what a big difference just simply bleaching the knots on a unit is. Now, like I said, I wanted to have a little experiment. I wanted to try the glueless method because it is hot out here in Arizona. Honey, we don't got time to be gluing wigs down. And you know, at the end of the day, with all of that sweat, we want to take that thing off, okay? But what you're going to do is take an elastic band and measure from ear to ear on the back of your head, and that's how you're going to be able to find out how much of the elastic band you need. And then obviously you're going to cut a reasonable amount of thread, just because, honey, you don't want it getting tangled as you're doing this, and obviously you don't need that much to sew it on each side. So once you go ahead and thread your needle, go ahead and tie it in a couple knots because you don't want it slipping out. I included this just because some people don't know how to thread a needle and tie a knot, and you know, they don't know what they're doing. So be patient with me if y'all already know this step. Thank you very much. But yeah, you're gonna tie the knot a couple times and then we're gonna go ahead and get to sewing. Now, the exact position I place the elastic is above each of the side combs. The reason I put it in that position, and I've seen several other people put it in that position, is because I know for a fact when I put units on, those side combs are definitely in the exact position they need to be. I've never really had any issues with them being in an awkward position or anything. So that's where I decided to thread it. Now, when I'm doing this, I'm going from bottom to top. You can definitely probably get a cleaner look if you go from bottom, from top to bottom. But here, what I'm doing when I thread it on the next side, I'm making a little loop. So I'll go ahead and show you guys one more time. I'm pushing that needle through and then I'm putting the thread around it, and then it's going to pull through and make a little like circle. I honestly don't know what this stitch is called. I am not a fashion designer by any means, but this is just how I sew. I don't know, I just learned this since I was like in Girl Scouts, y'all. I don't know. But anyway, you're just going to continue sewing this. Make sure you're not shifting your elastic too far up. I honestly could have pushed it back a little bit closer to where that comb was, but learn by my mistake, I guess. But at the end of the day, the amount of stitching I did definitely held it secure and didn't put as much tension on the lace. So at the end of that, you're just going to cut off any type of scraps you have and tie the string, and you should be good. All right, so now we are on our way to installing this bad boy. Now, honey, I look dusted, crusted, busted right here, okay? Don't clock me, I already know, but hey, I'm about to put a wig on. So I just did really quick messy braids and then combined them into 2 braids at the very back. And honestly, as long as the braids are pretty flat against your head, it should be fine. I typically do about 8 braids just because you don't want it lumpy and bumpy everywhere. You want it to be as flat as possible. But yes, once we go ahead and put this wig cap, honey, I still can't get over how I look with the wig cap. But as you can see, we're gonna go ahead and try it on for the first time, and y'all, it has been at least 5 months since I've like put a wig on, and I was just like, okay, we still that bad bitch, you know what I mean? But let me just say to you guys, like, look how nice this freaking hairline was. Like, honestly, I kind of think I'm over the baby haired phase. Like, you'll see later on in the video, I do baby hairs, but I kind of regret it. I think the next time I actually put this wig on and install it and do all that, I'm not gonna have any baby hair slicked down. I'm just gonna have it like a nice slick look, because I don't know, for some reason I was really digging it. But for now, we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit of foundation. I'm using the Urban Decay Stay Naked. I'm pretty sure that's shade 50 and N. I don't know, I switch in between, but I'm gonna apply that all around the wig cap, and then with whatever is extra on the brush, let me say that again, whatever's extra on the brush, then put it on the lace, because you don't want this liquid foundation. If you are using liquid foundation, I don't have powder, but you don't want it all runny and gross, because you are going to be applying some foam and you're going to be doing all this other stuff. You don't want it looking like smeared and stuff. But anyway, so now we're gonna go ahead and start cutting this lace off. Your girl was feeling herself. I was listening to music this entire time installing, so that's why we're here today with this voiceover. But we're just gonna go ahead and do some short little zigzags along the edge of the hairline. You don't want to cut this perfectly straight. And I mean, there's so many videos out there that say this and preach this, because then you're gonna have a very harsh line from where your natural skin meets and where the lace meets. So it's all about melting, it's all about blending it in. And honestly, look, like, this is before it's even laid down. I'm just like, ooh, is she feeling herself? And you know damn right well I was. Now, I don't have a hot comb or anything, so I'm just using part of my straightener to kind of lay this flat a little bit. And I also like parted it directly in the center because it was a little off. But here I'm gonna go ahead and put my hair in a ponytail and then section out a little bit of the baby hairs. Now, this unit does have a couple little baby hairs around the perimeter as well. Definitely fully customizable to your liking, which I really like. And like I said, the hairline already was pre-plucked and stuff, so it made things a lot easier. Now, this still might be a little bit full for some of y'all, so have fun with it. Pluck it if you need to. But here I'm gonna go ahead and apply some foam, and we're gonna be trying to finesse these baby hairs, honey. And let me just say, look at that. I'm struggling here, and I don't know why, because I feel like I perfected using bold hold and stuff like that in the bald cap method. I've practiced that so many times, and then for this to be like, cut the lace first, you know what I mean, and then use some hair foam to go ahead and style it and then wrap it, like, I don't know. I was just struggling. I haven't done baby hairs in a minute, y'all. That's why I said I kind of like the unit a little bit better without the damn baby hairs I added. But hey, we're just gonna continue through this. This is a realistic wig tutorial because I was trying to keep it real with y'all. All right. So anyway, after I did all that and styled it, I went ahead and put this silk scarf on around my perimeter and just started brushing it out and styling it. I will show you a couple products that I used in this hair, and they really worked so well together. So the first one is this John Frieda Frizz Ease, and this is the first time I even came across this product. And let me just say, it helped create the sleekest unit I've seen. Like, I loved how it turned out and definitely didn't frizz up. It did exactly what it said, more or less. And then I went ahead and applied a little bit on the top just to kind of get some of these flyaways down. And as you can see, it adds this very, very nice shine. Don't go too heavy on it. You don't want to look like the hair is greasy. And as you can see right now, it looks like a lot of products on it, but once I brush it out and do all this and that, it just looks perfect. So the perimeter of this unit still wasn't dry from all that foam wrap that I used, so I got my blow dryer and started blow drying it. And at the end, when it came down to it, I think I re-wrapped it about 3 times because I was not liking how the hairline was looking for these damn baby hairs. And like I said, it's nothing against this unit. It was just me. So at the very end, what I did, because I feel like it was the foam wrap I was using just wasn't cooperating, I just added a tiny bit of freeze blast along the perimeter, not underneath the unit, just right on top, just to kind of seal it in, like just using it as some hairspray, because I did not want this to lift up on the sides at all, because honey, there was a breeze out and we ain't trying to look all crazy. And then also for the front baby hairs in the right in the middle, I just decided to brush some of them back because it was definitely a little bit too thick for how much I had pulled out. And then, like I said, I just added a little bit of freeze blast. A little bit goes a long way with this product. It is very, very strong. So I just went ahead and did that and then cooled it. And then I went ahead and added a little bit of freeze blast onto those flyaways and used my little edge brush that I use for my natural hair to kind of just blend them all in together and seal it down. And then I went ahead and went in with this argan oil, dry Moroccan oil, I don't know. And it smelled so good and it just added the perfect amount of luster to this unit. I honestly was obsessed. Now, after everything was said and done, what I went ahead and did and brushed all the products through is I went ahead and started trimming the ends of this unit just to kind of get rid of any type of scraggly ends. And when I say scraggly, I mean like the unit came obviously pre-feathered, but I wanted more of a blunt cut on this unit. So that's what I went ahead and did. I just went ahead and cut straight across. And yes, those are hair cutting shears. I know they're cheap. Anyways, this is the final results. Obviously, all we had to do is make her glueless, bleach some knots, and straighten her, and then we were good to go. I know this video was super long, and I appreciate if you guys made it all the way to the end. Please leave a little white heart in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in the outro.
Alright guys, well that is it for today's video. I hope you guys found it helpful. I know I'm still in the learning process as well when it comes to doing new methods, and this one for some reason was a little bit challenging for me. I think it's because I'm so used to applying lace glue and going all in, doing the bald cap method, all that, the nines. However, I think with a little bit of practice, I can go ahead and get this method down fast, honey, because it was giving me a little bit of a hard time to go ahead and do this. And now I don't know if this foam that I'm using is a good foam to do this glueless method. However, I think it was also just my silk scarf being a little bit too thick to kind of dry it in time, because it was taking a while to dry. So I don't know if I will recommend this wrapping lotion when you're doing this method. There's so many other lotions out there, and honestly, you can go ahead and probably Google some better recommendations than this. This one I just grabbed on a whim, and it's honestly almost out, and I am not about wasting products, you guys. But other than that, I think that this wig was super easy to transform. The fact that the hairline already looked so nice when I took it out of the box, I'm so grateful for, because your girl does not like plucking and doing all that. The easier, the better, in my opinion. And honestly, I think this looks so bomb. The hair, when I took it out, didn't have any smell. And this hair, after straightening it, shampooing it, doing all the nines, very soft, very smooth, no tangling or anything else like that. All right, guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you guys found it helpful. I tried to be as detailed as possible during this entire process for you guys, because I know some of you all have not been in the wig game, and some of you are looking to get into it, so we all here to learn together. But anyways, that is it for this video, y'all. Don't forget to follow Unique Hair Supply on Instagram, as well as check out their website. They sell wigs, clip-in, extensions, you name it, honey, they got it. I will leave all this good information down in the description box below. But anyways, that is it for today's video, guys. I hope you liked it. I hope you learned something. And if you guys have any recommendations for me with the certain products I'm using or a better foam wrap, please go ahead and comment that down below. But anyways, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you liked it. And if you did, then don't forget to leave your girl a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one.